The most efficient way to improve the performance of a database query is to avoid it by retrieving the data from a local cache. That's why Hibernate offers three different caches, which are the first level cache that contains all entities loaded and created within the current session, the second level cache, which is a shared session independent cache for entities, and the query cache, which is a shared session independent cache for the results of criteria and JPQL queries. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen and I solve Java persistence problems for a living. In this video, I will focus on the query cache. It's Hibernate specific and the only one that doesn't store entities. That makes it your only option if you want to cache Dto projections. If you want to dive deeper into this topic, please take a look at my Hibernate performance tuning online training, in which I explain all three caches in great details. But before we start, if you are new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Dto projections are one of the best and easiest way to improve the performance of your read operations. In contrast to entities, which are part of the domain model and are used by multiple use cases, you can define a Dto projection for a specific use case that enables you to implement a query that only fetches the data that you need for your use case. Within that query, you can use all features supported by JPQL, like selecting attributes from multiple entities or using database functions to transform your data. And that's not the only reason why you should use them for read operations. As I showed in one of my previous articles, which you will find in the description, even if your Dto projection contains the same information as your entity, the Dto projection is significantly faster. The only downside of queries that return Dto projections is that the JPA specification doesn't offer any option to cache them. But you can use Hibernate's proprietary query cache for it. To use Hibernate's query cache, you first need to activate it in your persistence.xml file. In the next step, you need to explicitly activate caching for your query. This two-step activation is necessary because most of your queries are not a good candidates for caching. You should only cache the result of a query which you often call with the same set of bind parameter values. In addition to that, the data on which you perform your query should only rarely change. Otherwise, your query cache will not be very effective. It will spend more time adding and removing entries than actually returning cached query results. You can activate the query cache by setting the hibernate.cache.useQueryCache parameter in your persistence.xml to true. And if you want to use the query cache for any query that returns entities, you should also make sure to configure the second level cache for these entities. But that's a topic for another article, and I explain it in great details in my Hibernate Performance Tuning online training. After you activated the query cache, you need to tell Hibernate to cache the result of the query. You can do that in two ways. If you are using JPA's query interface, you can set the query hint queryHints.cacheable to true. If you are using Hibernate's query interface, you can call the setCacheable method with true. Both options create the same result. Hibernate checks the query cache before it executes the query. If the cache contains the result, Hibernate returns it without performing the query. If the result isn't cached, Hibernate executes the query and stores the result in the query cache. Let's give it a try. The following query uses a constructor expression and selects the title attribute of the book entity and the name attribute of the publisher entity. For each record returned by this query, Hibernate calls the constructor of the book publisher value class. In this example, I use JPA's query interface and activate the query cache with a query hint. If you activate the Hibernate statistics and the logging of SQL statements, you can see that Hibernate executes the query and stores the result in the cache. If you rerun the same code, Hibernate gets the query result from the query cache without executing the query. Dto projections perform much better than entities if you want to read data from the database. In this test, the Dto projection gave me about a 40% performance improvement. And your application will be even faster if Hibernate can skip the query and get the result from local memory. You can achieve that with Hibernate's query cache. You need to activate it in your persistence.xml configuration by setting the hibernate.cache.useQueryCache parameter to true. In the next step, you also need to activate the cache for a specific query by setting the query hint queryHints.cacheable on your JPA query or by calling the setCacheable method on Hibernate's query interface. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!